Here at Tangiwa is the location of one of New Zealand's largest volcanic disasters, and that was the 1953 Tangiwa disaster. And that's when the dam at Ruapehu Crater Lake broke out. There was a dam failure. The flood came down through here. And unfortunately, the original rail bridge behind us was taken out as the Christmas train was arriving and the train plummeted into the river. A crater wall collapse will generate a single lahar down the Whangahu Valley. That water then floods off down the volcano. It bulks up, and as it carries on, the bulk of it increases, and that gives it more energy. It starts to pick up bigger boulders. It starts to erode the banks of the river. And when we get to where we are here at Tangiwai, we actually impact on the first infrastructure, and they can do damage. On the other hand, a significant volcanic eruption in the Crater Lake can generate lahars into many different valleys draining off the summit of the mountain. Some of these could include the ski fields, in particular on the Whakapapa side of the volcano. Lahars are a significant volcanic hazard. Here at Mount Ruapehu, they're actually well mitigated for. We have the eruption detection system on the ski field that warns the skiers of lahars going through there. We've raised the height of the bridges, so the bridges are now several metres higher so lahars can go underneath them. And also about 7 or 8 kilometres upstream, we have warning devices now that detect the lahars and actually let us know that they're happening.